time to turn things up. This pre-workout combination of Expedite and Aerobatin is the Fat Attack Stack from Snack. I usually take both about 15 to 20 minutes prior to my workout. It's the perfect time to get after it.
Can Connor come back?
No.
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 He's done.
Yep.
Yeah?
So he had this. So I have a titanium plate on my leg too with nine screws.
Yeah.
And it hurts every time I kick. That's why. After the first Gilbert
fight.
How long
has it been?
It's been since after the first Gil fight in 2008. Jeez. So I've had it in there the whole time. Every time I've kicked with it, I wasn't able to kick with it. It actually affected the way that I fought because of that. No, so that was one of my biggest weapons when I won my world title, was that body kick on that side. Now if my ankle or my foot hits the elbow at all, it almost drops me. The other thing as well, if you were to put an ankle lock on that side, there's no flexion in it. So it literally, if you were to put an ankle lock, if you were to do a full Achilles lock on it, you could potentially break the bone over the plate because that uses as a fulcrum, that titanium plate. So the bone breaks over it. I broke it two or three times kicking someone's elbow over it and had to go back to a walking boot or a cast because of that scenario. So I got lucky that I was able to hide it long enough that people didn't realize it. Cause then I had to stop kicking with it though. And that was one of the biggest weapons that I had in my game on my rise to the top. Conor McGregor will never be the same fighter again. That leg being broken the way it is, whether it heals up, Chris Weidman right now went through the same thing. Sure, his came out of the skin a little bit, but he's having to go back in now for another surgery because it wasn't healing properly. Conor McGregor is only, what, a week and a half, 2 weeks removed? Doesn't mean anything. Like, in another month, he could say, hey, it's not healing properly, you gotta go back. So all of those type of things need to be considered. The other thing as well is every time he kicks, it could potentially break again. Oh, it's gonna be stronger. No, duh. That plate does not help it. It actually makes it worse. People need to remember that. People need to know that.
Yeah.
He could make a run in boxing though. Not in terms of real boxing. I think he can make a run at guys like Jake Paul. I think he can make a run at other guys. I'd like to see him fight Paulie Malignaggi. Let's see that fight. I mean, that's the fight that's been talked about. If you want to talk about YouTube guys making their run, Conor could jump right into that mix and do very well. He was trying to train for the Manny Pacquiao fight before he lost to Dustin the first time.
Yeah.
And so in his mind, he was thinking, I'm going to win this fight. I'm going to fight Manny, make hundreds of millions, maybe another 100 million or whatever it is. It made sense. But he lost that fight. But he was training nothing but boxing, getting ready for boxing. I think he has that feeling he wants to be a boxer. I think he's done with MMA. There's too many great wrestlers now. The Dagestani type, you know, Russian-style wrestlers are coming in. And he's never had great takedown defense. You know, he had it for the one fight against Khabib, but Khabib was just too good. And he wasn't able to work. And so I think his time has come. You know, he can't go down. He's not going to be able to go back to 45. He's too big. 55 is going to be a tough task because all those guys are savages there. I don't think he can beat Charles Oliveira because of the jiu-jitsu. I don't think he can beat, it can't beat Dustin Poirier. We've seen that twice now. You know, you put anybody else in that mix. Justin Gaethje would be a fun fight. He might be able to do it because Justin will stand with him.
He might get clocked too.
He might get clocked as well. So there's a lot of things that are there that, you know, we don't know.
Did you know after that injury that you weren't going to be the same?
No, I didn't know that.
You didn't know that?
No, I thought honestly I would have a lot more flexion.
I'm trying to think like, okay, like was it a point where you're like, I can still do it, but I'm not going to be at that level anymore, but fuck it, I'm just going to try to, you know, do it the best that I can.
We could have taken the plate out.
Yeah.
But when you take the plate out, right, and they take the screws out, they put, they fill the holes with bone grafts or whatever inside.
Yeah.
But then that takes 6 months to heal for it to be compressed and hard enough for you to go ahead and start kicking again.
Mm.
I said, well, what's the point? I've already taken 18 months off. Now I'm going to take another 6 months, you know, a year and a half later, and it can potentially break again. Just leave it in. So.
Where's the clamp that was missing?
That's because, you know, some people would see Anderson, you know, and be like, well, like, look at Anderson.
Yeah.
Connor can do that.
Yeah, but look at Anderson. Anderson never really kicked as much as he did after that fight. And then in terms of that, that's why he's doing boxing now, I believe.
Yeah.
You know?
That's true. Hey, Josh. Thanks so much. Appreciate it.
Pleasure, my man.
Yeah,
thanks for chatting.
Thank you so much for watching this video. And make sure to subscribe for more videos of your favorite fighters over here on Fight Up TV. And give us a follow online as well at Fight Up TV. On Twitter and on Instagram. We appreciate it, guys.